economic
inequality,
money,
gender uncertainty.
People have a shared feeling that there's a crisis in economic thinking.
We have a kind of attachment to the existing ways of thinking about economics, which needs to be challenged.
So it's a hugely urgent issue now that we come up with the right ideas to explain why these things happen. We have to rely on a lot of the young people to do this because the old ones are often beholden to the old ideas.
Right now, economics is a bit like a kind of established church where nobody is really allowed to think very differently. And like most established churches, they try to get you early and then brainwash you.
Sometimes academia is quite firmly based on certain ideas, certain ideological orientation, but I believe what ISAI provides for us to struggle against the establishment.
In order to start thinking about new kinds of paradigms and adapting to change in the future.
To be a good economist, one cannot only be an economist.
It's a project with a lot of heart.
YSI, the Young Scholars Initiative, is a group of young, very, very dedicated people from advanced undergraduates through graduate work who focus on economics from a skeptical perspective.
YSI basically is pretty important for sort of opening people's minds up fast.
I think it's really crucial to have face-to-face communication.
We are a community of global critical thinkers.
We're trying to break intellectual paradigms and build new ones.
It brings the enthusiasm of all of these different graduate students and master's and PhD students together.
And I've been just incredibly impressed by the intellectual energy, the degree of commitment to approaching economic issues.
I also like the diversity in it.
The diversity. And the fact that it's super inclusive. Like, I'm an example of this.
YSI came into existence rather, coincidentally, but it was one of those opportunities you had to seize.
This was an initiative of students from the very beginning.
On one hand, we have to pay very close attention to detail. That's what we're doing in all our working groups. We are working with very in-depth topics, while at the same time not losing track of the big picture.
They found this blend, right, between sort of face-to-face, small, slow, working through carefully, weekly meetings with a crowd that is the same every week so that you can really get into stuff, and then larger, and going back and forth. I think you need both.
The number of working groups which represent specific thematic interests has multiplied.
I think there's a good deal of interest in inequality, in injustice, in environmental issues. I do really like the fact that people are going into policy, going into consulting, working with businesses.
Communicating with scholars, learning from them, and also establishing relations with them.
Sharing and hearing will facilitate my future project. And then, most of all, meeting great scholars here is the best thing ever.
These people are setting an example of a community that can stay alive for a very long time.
I mean, academia is not just content, and it's also lasting relationships. This is also, I think, how the world works in a way.
20 years from now, I hope YSI is an enormous organization, a very significant proportion of the population of people who are aspiring to be economists. And there'll be a balance of power that will shift in favor of dynamism and flexibility, all the kind of things economists prescribe for the world when they run their own profession, like a polling bureau.
I think this will be a lifelong community.
It seems to me like a great place to get in touch with other people, find support, and get help in doing what you think economics really should be doing in the world.
That's a phrase that maybe gets used too often, but it very good encapsulated YSI. Be the change that you want to see.
I would say that if you want intellectual enrichment and collaboration across the globe with different perspectives on challenging economic paradigms, whether it's inequality, economic development, finance and law, this is the place to be. And we hope to contribute to society.
And that can change the world.